So, yes, the space shuttle still retired, but you'd be surprised which key components are going to fly again and help get astronauts into space. Hey everybody, welcome back to I Need More Space, a show brought to you by a guy who is now just realizing how hard it is to get a video up every week because these take so much damn time. So yeah, the space shuttle stopped in 2011, God rest its soul, but many of its key components still have a future in NASA's space launch system. You might ask why, that's all old technology, and there's good reason, we'll get back to that. So let's start with the boring stuff, the fuel tanks. Okay, so the fuel tank that's going to be used on the SLS is not exactly the same fuel tank from the shuttle, but think of it as its big brother. The two designs are essentially the same, just the SLS one is bigger. Much like everything else on the SLS, it's the space shuttle, but bigger and more technology. The new SLS tank holds 36% more than the old shuttle tank, so it's going to have some more fuel to burn. Next on the bigger and better trend, we are on to the engines. Attached to that fatty of a fuel tank, we have the RS-25 engines, the same exact engines that flew on the shuttle. So identical, in fact, that three of the first four flying on SLS actually flew on the shuttle before. Currently, there are 16 RS-25 engines in inventory, all built for the shuttle, and 9 have flown already. With those 16 engines in inventory, that means NASA has about enough engines for 4 future flights. The RS-25 engines that were originally designed in the 70s will have updated engine controllers attached, basically just a new brain. This controller will monitor the fuel mixture and communicate with the guidance computer to make sure fuel is being consumed more efficiently than before. NASA contractor Aerojet Rocketdyne signed a new contract in 2015 to build 6 more RS-25 engines, but these will be cheaper. So in comparison, these engines will be cheaper, but it's because they're designed to fly only once, and they're also going to be using modern engine building techniques. The solid rocket boosters on this bad boy are the same-ish as well, but also bigger. It's the same base design again, but with one more propellant segment. So yeah, just like the fuel tank, it's going to burn longer, and it has some more modern computers on board, but I'll spare you the details. The final engine recycled into the SLS is the service module main engine, known as the Space Shuttle Orbital Maneuvering System. It's those two little engines you see above the shuttle's RS-25s. The one flying on the first SLS mission has already flown on 19 shuttle missions between 1984 and 2002. So yes, these sound like old engines and they have a lot of use already, but they were designed for 100 flights, so they have a lot of runway left on them. So to come back at the question from the top of the video, why is NASA using all this old technology? Well, for a couple really good reasons. One, NASA is super risk averse and they want to use technology they know works, and the space shuttle had 134 flights. A lot of testing on these components and NASA just knows they work. Also, the facilities exist to manufacture these components. I mean, if you're gonna select a new engine to put in this rocket, you need to basically create a whole new manufacturing process for materials and training and all the logistics. It's a lot easier for NASA to take an engine that has worked very successfully in the past and just modernize it. The third and final reasoning for using this old tech is really politics. You see, the congressman who agreed to move forward with the SLS project did not want the jobs that existed already in the factories to build these engine components to leave and go somewhere else if NASA chose to go with new technology. So it was basically a rider for Congress to say, yeah, you can go ahead and build your rocket, but we want the jobs to stay. This isn't all bad though, because really NASA is keeping a lot of the experience that they've been building up for decades with these contractors, and this is really valuable when you have tight schedules. So do you think it was a smart decision for NASA to use this existing technology, or do you think that this is stifling innovation? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks a lot for watching, please subscribe, and I'll catch you guys later. Thanks a lot.